everyone. Hi Radhika, so good to see you here. Hi everyone. Hi Iftizam. Hi. Hi Ruchira. Okay, so how you guys, all guys are doing? Hi Rawali. Hope you all are doing good, staying safe, taking all the precautionary measures and are creative. Hello everyone. Okay, so I'm a bit nervous and super excited to launch my new designer grid books, my mandala design grid books, which I think is really, really important in a mandala artist's life, right? Because we need to get those patterns perfectly fine. We don't need to get the symmetry in them. So I have brought a grid book which is quite affordable, and also it has all the features that you need necessary for your fine liners to work smoothly, and it's smudge proof, it's bleed proof, and it's 100 GSM paper. So I'll, without wasting any time, flip the camera to the other side so that you can have a look. Hi Sneha. Alright, so I'll just flip the camera around. Alright, so hello everyone who joined in just now. So what we are doing is, here I am for the live demonstration of two of my mandala grid books which I have launched recently, and you can see the upper page is here, the one with my design over here. So I found these two designs perfectly suitable for these grid books, and thank you everyone for sharing your views on this. So let me just open this up and show you what I've got inside. So these are the inside of the grid books. As you can see, they are grid sheets with a standard grid size of 5x5 mm, so that it's perfectly suitable for all of our mandala artists here, so that we can get the perfect kind of measurements, perfect kind of patterns. And also it's a 100 GSM of white map litho paper, so it's quite vibrant, quite white. It's not in an off-white or a beige kind of a shade, and also it's completely bleed proof. So I have used my fine liners over here, and if I just revert it back on the other side, you can see it's completely bleed proof. And also what we do is we face different kind of grid sheets which even if they don't bleed, they revert your designs or anything on the other half of the page, so that you cannot use your backside of the paper as well. So this is something which I kept in mind, and I have brought something that it won't bleed or show off on the backside of your paper as well. All right, so this is the thing. Hi Purvi. So what we are doing is, I am introducing you all to my newest journal, my newest mandala grid books, which I have recently launched, and we will be also practicing a few of the mandala patterns together, focusing on the fact that how these papers work and why I really, really love having a mandala grid book for pattern practicing. Thank you so much, Heartworks Hub. So glad you liked it. So the same is for this one as well. All of the sheets are grid sheets, so that you have plenty of grid sheets to practice off. There are 50 sheets over here, so it equals to 100 pages, and it is made in India. So that's a really good thing that I'm proud of. Thank you so much, Iftizam, for your loveliest comment over here. Glad I could have a bit of release. Purvi, if you don't have them, you can get these grid books from our art store, which is exclusively at a very reasonable and affordable price of rupees 180. And also, if you wish, you can get a combo of a grid book and a fine liner of 0.01 mm with it, which is just at rupees 245 only. So I thing which I have worked on is getting a very affordable grid sheet, so that you can go ahead and purchase it without worrying about the difficult the higher price range or anything for that matter of fact. Okay, and also I have provided you with 100 GSM of paper, so that it's completely bleed proof. You do not need to worry about the ink getting blotted or ink getting smudged off or ink getting bled to the next back side of the page or it's showing off. So this is something I've really really worked on, getting a very high quality of paper so that it's perfectly suited to you, and it's a super smooth paper, rid of any grain so that you have the fine ink flowing throughout it. All right, also what it is, it's completely suitable for mandala art. It works well with fine liners, it works well with fountain pens, it works well with gel pens, it works well with acrylic markers or permanent markers if you wish to go for, and it doesn't bleed off that at all. So I'll just show you a bit of thing that I did with the Brustro marker over here. That is, I just scribbled it out so that I could see if it, with a very dark filling, if it shows off. So I just, you can see it doesn't, and it's a single sheet of paper only. Okay, so with this much of filling with my acrylic marker, I haven't got any bleeding or any show through on the other half of the paper. Rawali, this is available in just one size for now, and it's available in A5 size, but I'm working on making it available in different size. The price of the grid books here are ₹180 each, excluding the shipping. And also you can get a combo of the Brustro fine liner 0.1 mm over here at ₹245 only. So you can get a grid book and a fine liner combo at ₹245, or just the grid book of your choice from these two at ₹180. So this is the price. Hi Shivani, I'm doing good, so good to see you here. So this is the thing. So let me just brief you, just keeping this one aside, because I have done the patterns on this one. This is my personal favorite, but you can go for any of the favorite you like. So I'll share with you all the links after we end this live session on my stories, and it's also in my bio of my Instagram handle, so you can get them, and they are really really affordable for now. So I'm keeping the launch offer till this month, till the end of this month, so grab them, and I have a very limited stock, so grab them before they get out of stock as well. And also, if you go ahead and book any of them within the 12 a.m. today, so you can get them shipped by tomorrow as well. So opening up my grid book here, it comes with a very sturdy biro binding, as you can see, so you can easily move around the papers on the other halves and it won't hamper your works, and you can work perfectly fine with a full sheet. Or if you wish to go ahead and tear them off as well, that's also can be easily done. Now to me, let me just first explain you all a bit about why the grid sheet is something that I pitch in for, or that I feel is very very necessary. Is for me, the grid sheets is the grids are something for forming the foundation of my mandala patterns, or the base of my mandala patterns, and it's very very important to get your base strong or your foundation strong, so that even when you go ahead and work with freehand, you have that measurement in your mind and you can go on eyeballing with them. Hi Padmavati ji, you haven't missed a lot of it. I'm just introducing my grid books over here, which comes in two different designs, and it's in an A5 size over here, which is what I feel is a good amount of size, and you can get each of these grid books of 50 sheets, which is 100 pages, at ₹180, which is the launch offer for now, going on till the end of this month. And also you can get a combo offer of the grid book and the Brustro fine liner 0.1 mm at ₹245 as well. So as I was saying, hello everyone, so glad you could all join in the launch of my newest grid books. These are the grid books. It's available in this design as well as another design over here. Let me just show you, so you can go ahead and grab any of your favorites. It's made up of white map litho paper of 100 GSM, so it's completely breathproof, and I have used my fine liners here, and it doesn't shows off through the other side of paper as well. So being a very high quality GSM and a very sturdy and smooth paper, it doesn't bleed off on the other half or doesn't show off on the other half of my paper as well, so that I can use both side of my papers if I wish to. And you can go ahead and use any markers, any fine liners, any colored brush pens, jelly rolls, fountain pens, anything on this surface except for wet medium. to suit yourself, and it's perfect for mandala artists. Artists by Ankita, you can get them from my store. The link is in my bio, and after this live session end, I'm going to put up the story with all the given links as well, so you can get them from here. Right now, if you wish to go ahead and check them out, you can go ahead and see the link in your bio. Yes, Padmavati ji, they are available in my store right now, and the launch offer is till this month, end of this month, you can get them. They are in a very limited quantity, so you can grab them before they go out of stock. And due to the situation given here, it was a great deal of time to get them shipped to me. So you can go ahead, because I don't know when I will be able to restock them. So, as I was saying before we get started and practice few of our mandalas, is as I was saying, these are the basics or the foundations of any mandala. Himadri, I'm using a Brustro 0.1mm fine liner over here. Hope it's visible. So, this is my go-to pen if I have to go on making any grid any patterns on my grid book, or this standard size of 5x5mm grid boxes. Now, also I really really recommend and pitch for it, even if in my workshop, in my live sessions, in anywhere I go ahead and teach on my YouTube channel as well, that practicing your patterns on a grid sheet is really really important, so that you get the perfect symmetry and the neatness in your pattern shapes. And even if you wish to go ahead and later on and switch to freehand, which I don't personally feel is necessary, if you still feel to go ahead and do a freehand patterning, you'd still have that perfect eye measurement that you have been practicing of that, right? So I feel that grid practice is very one of the very important factors in case of mandalas, so that you get the neatness, you get the perfect kind of pattern detailings and everything. Himadri, I have few of my workshops lined up. You can check the link in bio or message me after this live session ends, and I'll help you out there. So this is something which I go ahead and teach in each of my first workshops or on my sessions about patterns, because they get to form the mandalas. Yeah, they work completely well on my grid sheets. I had used them over here, as you can see the marker over here, which isn't bleeding on the three mother side of paper. And this is just the single sheet, I'm not using a double sheet or something like that. So this is the marker that I use. This is the Brustro acrylic marker which I used here. Karkina, this is the my newly launched Vivi Trails newly launched mandala grid books, which is suitable for your mandala pattern practice or grid mandalas if you wish to go ahead. Arts and Drawing, it's Vivi Trails. You can check the YouTube from there, and I go ahead and upload a few of the stories, so you can go ahead and swipe up from there as well. So this is the grid sheet I'm pitching in for today, which I have personally curated over here. Elsinia Art, this is my newly launched grid book, which you can get from our art store. The link is in my bio, so you can go check it out, and after these live session ends, I will surely go ahead and keep up a story with a swipe up link, so that you can go ahead and purchase them. They are at rupees 180 for now, till the end of this month. And you can also get a combo offer of these grid books, either this one or the design of this one, with the combo offer of Brustro fine liner as well at ₹245. So anything, you can go ahead and grab them before it's too late. Yeah, exactly. So I guess I'm not going to go ahead and that. So what we're going to do is we're going to go ahead and practice few of the patterns, and I'll go ahead and describe how this practicing patterns on a grid sheets helps you throughout. So what I'll do is, as I'm practicing the patterns on these grid sheets, these 5x5mm grid boxes, it helps me to go ahead and work on things about how you can go ahead and plan out your patterns. You can keep them for your later use as well. So if you are stuck and what pattern you wish to go for, you can have a look at it and you can go ahead and experiment with it. Go ahead and make grid mandalas if you wish to go for making them as well. So starting off the practice, I go ahead and use the 0.1 mm as my standard pen size for grid mandalas or working on my grid sheets. You can use either a 0.05 or a 0.03 mm as well, whichever fineliner you are comfortable to use with. So what I do is I usually go ahead and use even number of grid boxes so that I have the symmetry in my patterns and they are uniform all over. So what I'm doing over here for just this exceptional case of this elliptical kind of a shape, I'm using only one grid boxes. Yes, Purvi, this IGTV will be saved, so you can always go ahead and scrap back to this if you feel like you're missing out on patterns or you want to know more about my grid sheets. So what I'm doing is I'm going ahead and drawing this elliptical shape using one single grid box. This is how I measure even if I'm going for a freehand pattern detailing as well, so that I have this perfect kind of measurements. Even if I go ahead and use a blank paper, I know that this is somewhat approximately area or the width that is to be needed to go ahead and create this. And as I said, I always go ahead and use even number of grid boxes. For the next one, I'm using two grid boxes and making a curved triangular shape, or also known as the pointed arc shape over here. For the next one, I'm going for adding a swirl using just a single grid box from the top or the midpoint of the previous pattern shape. Okay, so I always tend to combine my patterns from the midpoint of the previous pattern shape so that I have enough space to fill in my detailings with. I'm making a swirl here, joining it from the below half, another one from in the opposite direction over here. And next, what I'm going to do is again I'm going to make this pointed arc shape or this curved triangular shape, but again I'm going to use four grid boxes to make a bigger one. So this is how I go ahead and make bigger pattern shapes whenever I need it. And before I go ahead and fill in with any of my detailing, this is something I very personally prefer, is go on for a double outlining or making the same pattern shape, leaving a bit of a marginal gap in between before I go ahead and fill on any detailing so they are neat and clean and the pattern detailing doesn't get hidden. Thank you so much, Rakhi. This arts and drawing, I started mandala 3 years back, so that's when I get started, and I have never looked back since. So each day I go on practicing ahead. Yes, Himadri, this IGTV will be saved, so you can always go ahead and look at it. So for the first detailing in this miniature elliptical shape, what I'm doing is I'm going for a simple semicircle, and on top of it I'm adding a little circle, so, and I'm filling off the remaining white spaces. So this is how I go ahead and fill in my detailings. I do not go for very intricate kind of pattern detailings. I tend to prefer a bit of geometric or floral embellishments so that they are intricate. And what I do is I tend to go ahead and fill the double outlining or make the pattern detailings a bit bolder so that they cover up more of space and it's not completely blank, or I have to fill it with black detailings. For the next one, I'm making a leaf like structure just in this middle of this pattern shape and adding two lines on both of the sides and just a line and a dot on top inside of that. So this is how I'm filling this one. For in between my two swirls, I filled with just a circle, and for this bigger kind of pointed arc shape, I'm topping it off with a little circle in the midpoint. So this midpoints also go ahead and helps you keep the uniformity on both half of your pattern shapes. And I'm topping it off with the petal-like structure, which is like a reverse tear droplet or water droplet, and two on either sides of the main petal. Filling off just a bit of remaining white spaces that I have available, and I tried to just go ahead with as bold as the petals can be, so that I do not go on scrunching or cramping up too many of the petals in one of the area to make it look intricate. That's not how you make your patterns look intricate. Try and work with your elements, fill them off rather than going on cramping too many different elements in one go. And if you feel like these blank petals are very, very blank and it's not so intricate, what you can do is just to enhance them, go ahead and draw 3/4 line in between them to make it look much more intricate. So I'll just zoom in for you all a little bit so that it's easier for you all to see. And in between these two pointed arc shapes, what I'm doing is I'm going ahead and making a leaf-like structure which is pointed at the tip, adding a line and a dot and two little circles on either side of it. So here we are done with our first pattern. Thank you so much, Shumana. Thank you, Edge Creations. Thank you, Kavya. So glad you like it. And let me show you, after I have done this pattern detailing over here, it hasn't popped up on the other half of my paper. So this was I was saying that it's completely bleed-proof. You cannot see it from through the other half. So this page or the back side of your page doesn't go into waste. So if you wish to go ahead and practice it on this half as well, you can do that. Which sometimes whenever we are using a bit of low quality GSM of paper, it shows through. So this is what I faced when I was using the previous grid books of mine, which I felt were very, very thin and very, very of a bit of lower GSM in quality, so that it was see-through, so I was not able to use the back side of my page or even go ahead and put too much pressure on one piece of paper, because it used to go ahead and stamp it off on this half of the paper. So this is what I kept in mind while I was working and finding the right paper for my grid sheets. And Anupa, this is my newly launched grid book, so you can get them from our art store. The link is in bio, and we are having a launch offer for this going on right now, so you can go ahead and get them. These are my designer grid books over here with my designs. Edge Creations, these are my grid books which I have recently launched, keeping all of the mandala artists and the people who use grids on a daily basis for practicing. So you can go ahead and get them from my store at a discounted price for now. So you can check the link in bio over here. It's also very, very good and super useful for lettering artists as well, or any people who go ahead and use grids. So I'm saving you a bit of time for not going on drawing out each and every grid of yours, or going ahead and printing tons of paper, or finding tons of paper and going ahead and printing it out. So this is completely 100 GSM white matte litho, so it's a very smooth white paper. It's not of a beige shade or a natural shade. White paper, completely bleed proof, suitable for markers, suitable for brush pens, jelly rolls, fine liners, acrylic markers or permanent markers as well. Thank you so much, the hard works up. I'm just keeping in mind something which I needed for a lot of I needed for a long time, and I'm glad I could work on this and go ahead and provide something at an affordable price, because sometimes the grid books are quite at a higher range and it's not that affordable to each and every people. So this is not, and you can also go ahead and get them with the combo of the Brewster fine liner of 0.1 mm as well. So moving on to my next pattern detailings over here, as I said again, I go on using even number of grid boxes. So I'm going for this curved triangular shape using two grid boxes, two in the sense because I want a smaller size of this pattern shape. If you wish to go for a bigger size, you can go ahead and use more number of grid boxes, but make sure you use it in even numbers so that you get this midline passing through your patterns so that it's evenly distributed on both halves. Hi Ishita, so nice to see you here. Glad you could join in my live launch of my QuickBooks. So what I did was fill in with a little swirl and a circle combination, which is not quite it. And what you can do is also go ahead and use any kind of geometric shapes or motifs to fill in your pattern detailings. There isn't something that you need to be specific of. You can always go ahead and explore and experiment. For the next pattern shape, I'm going ahead and drawing a square or an elliptical kind of a shape which has curved edges. Thank you so much, Ragini. And for this one, I'm using 4 grid boxes, as you can see. My painting stores, the cost of this grid books is, for time being at till the end of this month, is ₹180 for just a single one. And if you wish to go ahead and buy at a combo of Brewster fine liner and the grid book, it's ₹245. And inside of this, what I'm doing in this elliptical shape, so I'm going ahead making a smaller circle in between the pattern shape, going for a straight line, a curve, bit inwards, and then pulling it outwards, a semi half paisley over here. And I try to call it or make it easier, it's like an art kind of a shape. So this is how you go ahead and do it, and making the same thing on the opposite direction, starting from the midline. On the top of it, I'm again making a leaf kind of structure, pointed leaf, drawing a midline from this pointed leaf and going ahead and filling it with tilted lines on both halves, and lines and dot in this remaining half. And what I'm doing is, I'm just to fill this semi half paisleys, I'm just outlining it, leaving a bit of gap, the shape, and filling it off completely. So for new pattern shapes, what you can do is always go ahead and mix and match different kind of elements. Try and explore your pattern detailings, mix and match, go ahead and mix and match with the shapes, mix and match with the elements, use any other geometric elements in a bit of different way to create your new patterns. For the next one, what I'm doing is I'm just creating 2 little swirls, starting from again the midpoint. If you can see, I'm using the midline here whenever I'm combining my pattern shapes or adding any layer. Using a complete grid box, drawing a swirl, another one from the opposite direction, and filling this mid area with just a single circle. And for the top half, what I'm doing is, first from the in between of this swirls, I'm creating the leaf like structure over here, and in between them I'm creating a bit of a semicircular like structure to completely fill it off. Again, I'm going for double outlining each and every pattern of mine so that it's completely neat and clean. In between this semicircular, I'm adding a midline and a dot using the midpoint, and 2 smaller dot and line from either sides, and just a line in this leaf like structure. Thank you so much, Chetna. Glad you like it. Gibbet and art. Yes, I will be saving this IGTV, so you can always go ahead and scrap back to the pattern detailings that we are going ahead and doing. Alright, just shift it a bit. For the next pattern shape or pattern detailings, what I'm doing, or the combination of patterns, is I'm starting off with swirls, starting from the outer side towards the inward side so that they join in the mid area, using just a single grid box. And you can see this grid box really, really helped me in perfecting the patterns. And even if I go ahead and draw them in numbers, still each and every one of them are symmetrical and uniform. Thank you so much, all of you, for appreciating my work. And what I'm doing is, I am going ahead and adding the pointed arc shape using 2 grid boxes. I'm going for the smaller pointed arc shape, the curved triangular shape. Again, going for double outlining. For this detailing, I am drawing a midline from this pointed arc shape, going for side view petals, two side view petals only, so that they are big and bold enough. And for the other half, what you can do is you can just leave them black or just fill them in or add circles. What I'm doing is I'm adding tilted lines. So there are plenty of options you can play around with. And when you're creating or doubting the creation of your new pattern detailings, what you can do is use a pencil first. So there is no kind of shame in using a pencil first. So you can go ahead and use a pencil first and then redo it with the fine liner. And next I'm adding a triangular shape, again a smaller triangular shape using two grid boxes only. Thank you so much, Pinky Alicia, for the kindest words. And thank you everyone who has joined in for the live demo of my grid sheets. Again, I'm double outlining these triangular shapes as well. And I'm starting off from each of the corner, making a petal kind of a shape and bringing it down in the middle or in between, and doing the same from the opposite half and going ahead and topping it off with a circle and filling off the remaining white area. I'm using the tip size 0.1 mm of Brustro over here, which I find it quite easy to use whenever I'm working on a 5x5 mm grid size. For the next shape, again I'm using just two grid boxes only, and I'm going for the elliptical shape or a curve kind of square or with square with a rounded edges. Again going for double outlining, and to fill this off, what I'm doing is I'm using the technique of hatching. So even you can go on using the shading techniques, which are hatching and stippling, to fill in your pattern detailings if you wish to. You do not need to only stick to motifs or geometrical shapes over here. You can go ahead and use shading techniques as well. So what I do is whenever I'm shading from the inward side, I rotate my paper so that when I'm pulling out the pen, it's towards me, so that easier for you to hatch. So I'm pulling it out the continuous lines, which are not very elongated, which come till the mid area of the pattern shape. And next, again when I'm doing the upper area, what I'm doing is I go ahead and start it from the top half, bringing it down to the middle area, leaving a bit of white areas in the middle to give a highlight effect. Dip it in art, my each shape comes equally or symmetrically, because I always go ahead and use grids. Even if I'm practicing my patterns, I use grid sheets like this one, which I have brought to you all. So I use the grid sheet. Even if I'm drawing a mandala, I go ahead and make a mandala grid, so that all of my pattern shapes or all of my detailings or all of the patterns that I'm adding are symmetrical and equal and are uniform all throughout. And that's the speciality of the mandala that you need. It must be symmetrical and equal. So keep this in mind whenever you're going ahead and practicing mandalas, to use grids for the perfect symmetry. Now in between this elliptical shapes, I'm topping it off with a little circle and three petals. First petal starting from the midpoint over here again, and another one on the side. Same way on the other half as well. And in between these two little petals, I'm filling it off with a bigger kind of a circle and adjoining to them two little circles. And I'm filling off the remaining area, and to make the petals look a bit more intricate, I'm adding a bit of line, 3/4 line in each of them. So here we are done with our third kind of pattern detailing as well. So this is how we go ahead and I go ahead and practice my patterns. As you can see, I use similar kind of pattern detailings, but in a different way or different manner or different angle to make it unique or make it different from the other ones. Yes, chaina.p, you can go ahead and create it in your style, no worries. You can go ahead and use them to practice as well and incorporate them in your mandalas also. Yes, the movement of words, I will be saving this IGTV, so you can always go ahead and look back at it. Moving on to the fourth one over here. For this one, what I did was I started off with two little triangles, triangular shape using two grid boxes. Again, going for double outlining. And if you see over here, just use the element circle in just various sizes. So for the first one, I started from the middle, creating a bigger circle and joining to them two little circles over here to complete off or fill this this pattern detailing. Then completely filling off the remaining white areas to make the circles pop out. For the next pattern shape, again I've gone for elliptical shapes or using two grid boxes. Again, going for double outlining them. What I did to fill off in this middle area is you can add another shape in between a pattern shape so that you can go ahead and fill the two shapes in a different way, and it helps you not to worry too much about such a big area or such a huge area. So you can always subdivide it. So I'm drawing a little semicircular kind of shape in this elliptical shape, filling it off with a dot and a line. The artworks, that's such a sweet thing to do. Thank you so much, Chetna. It's so lovely to have a generous comment by you. Arts and drawing, I really prefer the double outlining because it provides such a neatness to your detailings, making it prompt out. And what I'm doing is to fill this remaining area in this elliptical shape, I'm making the leaf-like structure, the pointed leaf structure, and to that I'm adding side petals to form like an elliptical shape. So I'm drawing a diagonal line from this side on each of the sides and then curving it out and bringing it down, filling off the remaining white areas. And then just adding little 3/4 line to make the petals look intricate. Hello Shubhoda, glad you could join in. For the next pattern shape, again I'm going for the pointed arc shape, but this time I'm using 4 grid boxes for a bigger pattern shape. And this is the real time video, as you can see. So this is how slowly I work on my patterns. I do not rush, I take my own time. And if you're new at it, whenever you're new at it or whenever you're starting off your pattern detailings, always start slow. Okay, try to put in all your concentration over here. If you're new, start by using the pencil first and then redoing with the fine liner, so that your hands will have a dual practice and your hands will get steadier. Try to control your breathing. Breathe in and breathe out slowly and steadily so that your hands do not come out cheeky if you're going ahead and trying it out with the fine liners on one go only. Again, going for the double outlining here. Thank you so much, Shubhoda. Moksha Doodles, I'm using the 0.1mm fine liner here, which I feel is a standard size for the 5x5mm grids. To fill on this pointed arc shape or this bigger pointed arc shape, what I'm doing is I'm going for starting from the midline, going for a semi-half paisley on one half till using only one grid. I haven't touched the second grid yet. I'm starting from the patterns, tilted from the sideways towards the middle area and adding the patterns as many as I can fit in here and completing it off with this little circle because I had space. So if you wish, you can go ahead and complete it off with another petal, or you can just fill in it out as well. Okay, there's nothing compulsory that you need to do it, as I'm doing it only. Okay, normally doing the shape on the right and left side leaf is difficult to come equally. Can I? Yeah, sure. If it is not, whenever you're doing the petal kind of a structure or any kind of shape, pattern shape, it may come out a bit different from your left hand side or your right hand to your right hand side, because we usually we are just a single hand person, right? We cannot walk on two ways. So what we need to do is, you can go ahead and use your pencil first, which I sometimes go ahead and do till now as well, so that you can go ahead and work if the shapes are symmetrical. So suppose this is the next shape which I messed it up. So what I can do is, I can go ahead, erase it off over here. My eraser had colored. Okay, fine. So, and then again redo it correctly with your pencil. And then what you can do is redo it with your fine liner, so that it happens to be a dual practice, and you tend to get used to making the pattern shapes over and over again to make them symmetrical. Alright, so this is what I do. Practice, use the pencil first, redo it with the fine liner so that you have the symmetry in there. And dependent art, I'm using my own newly launched grid sheets over here. You can get them from our art store. The link is in bio. And thank you so much, all of you, to pouring in so much of love. So to complete this off over here, in between, what I'm doing is, I'm going for a little swirl using a bit more than one grid area, and going for petals on top of it, again using the midpoint so that it's almost symmetrical, and adding two side petals on each side, filling it out with a bit of 3/4 lines to make it look more intricate. So finally, sorry for the bit of disruption. Hope I am audible. You can just give me a thumbs up before we move on to the next pattern detailing over here. Alright, so I guess I'm audible enough, and the video is working again. We are facing a bit of network issues, but hopefully this is fine now. Alright, thank you, Chetna. Thank you, Nifty Thrifty Arts. Glad you like the patterns. Now moving on to the final pattern detailing. For this one, what I'm doing is, I'm going ahead and making a elliptical shape using 4 grid boxes. Art by Gautami, if you wish to go ahead and make a complete mandala for practice, you can definitely do it on a grid sheet. But if you're going ahead and making it a final piece of paper, a circular kind of mandala, you need to stick to the blank sheets. And we have blank notebooks as well, or you can go ahead and purchase Brustro papers, Bristol papers, drawing papers, whichever suits you the best. Depend on art, I prefer the Brustro over here, which I find it quite pigmented and they do not fade away even after erasing. So I prefer the Brustro ones, but you can go ahead and try it on your own and figure out which one works better for you. Arts and drawing, due to lack of practice, that may happen that your hands start to shiver. So what you can do is try to breathe in as steadily as possible, or holding your breath for at least 10 seconds while you're working on the pattern, or as I said, first working on the with the pencil first and then moving it to the fine liner so that it comes out more and more steadily. Now for this one, what I'm doing is, I'm starting off from the midpoint, making 2 semi-half pastels. Starting from the midpoint towards the outward side, opposite to each other, and I'm making a little kind of an outline to this, a bit of curved straight line shape, and filling this little area with a tiny little circle. So you can just leave the semi half pastels blank as well, but if you want to make it look intricate, you can draw a bit of shape in it and go ahead and then just add a bit of detailing, a line and a dot. The back side of the book or the grid book looks is the same wrist design, but just in a bit of more lighter tone, more off focus or opacity lower kind of a tone over here, so that the front page covers all the attention. And it has all the specifications over here. It's made in India. It has 50 sheets. They are 100 GSM paper over here. So these are the specifications written on the back side of the book. And to top it off, this parsley is what I'm doing is I'm making the petals, again the mid petal and two side petals. What you can do is add a mid petal and then complete it off with two little circles, or you can go ahead and just add a line kind of detailings as well, anything you wish to go for. For the next pattern shape, combine it off. What I'm doing is again starting off from the midpoint of the previous pattern shape, going ahead and drawing the pointed arc shape or the triangular, curved triangular shape. Again going for double outlining it. And for this one, what I'm doing is going ahead and drawing the leaf, pointed leaf like structure, drawing a line and a dot. And to this remaining other halves, thank you so much, Mandala with Sisters. So this over here is somewhat the shape that I had used over here as well, as you can see, right? So it's similar kind of shape, but what I did was switching the elements to experiment with, and I made something which is quite different from this one. This is more towards the lighter tone, while this is more towards the bolder and darker tones. Hi Anjali, thank you so much. And what I'm doing in this sides is, rather than going for the line and dot, I'm going for a bigger circle at the end and a little circle on top of it. And filling it out. Thank you so much, Artspy got me. And to this, what I'm doing is I'm again going for the pointed arc shape, the bigger pointed arc shape, using four grid boxes. Again going for double outlining before I fill off with any kind of detailing, adding a swirl in the middle half or in between the pattern shapes over here, adding a double outlining to my swirl as well. And what I'm doing is I'm going ahead with a semi half paisley only, but in a bit of different way. My painting stories, yes, these fine liners, the Brustro fine liners, work perfectly fine on Brustro canvas. Also depending upon the texture of the canvas and the grains of the canvas, if they have smooth and fine grains, it will definitely work, but do not use on it on a rough grain kind of a canvas, otherwise it will damage the tips. So it works well with Brustro canvases or canvas boards, so you can go ahead and use them. My painting stories, there are different sizes of Brustro fineliners, and they have newly launched their 1mm as well. So they are thinner than the markers but thicker than the fineliner. So you can go ahead and purchase them. And what I'm doing is going for the semi half paisley, drawing from the mid half, curving it out and bringing it out like this, so that this has a bit of a more elongated area. Repeating on the other half as well. And in the middle half or in between these patterns, what I'm doing is I'm making just a single petal kind of a structure, filling off the remaining space, adding a little dot. And to this semi half paisley also, what I'm doing is I'm just adding a line and dot to make it look more intricate. And in between these structures, I'm just adding a little swirl, just one single inward curve and two little circles on either side. So this was it for our patterns. I'm going to zoom it out for each one of you to see this, and I'll just wait for a few more minutes and you can pop up your questions over here, anything you have. Thank you so much, by Art Card by Shweta, glad you like it. These are the patterns that we did today on my newly launched grid box, and I'm just showing you the other half of the paper after I'm done as well. I go ahead with my usual pressure only, but it doesn't show off or doesn't create pen marks on the other half, as you can see, doesn't bleed. And let me show you with a bit of acrylic markers as well, so that you understand that these are completely straightforward even if you go ahead and use acrylic markers. I'm just shifting to the last paper for you. And I'm using the Bruce Show DIY acrylic marker, which is quite pigmented. And what I'm doing is I'm just completely filling off this area. And you can see it doesn't shows off. On the other half, if you watch it against light, you can see it, but it doesn't shows off anyways, or doesn't bleeds on the other half. So what you can do is you can go ahead and use acrylic markers as well on top of it if you wish to go for. If you are a lettering artist, you can definitely use your brush pens as well. I'm going ahead and showing you with the metallic brush pens because they are quite more pigmented than the regular ones, so that you are able to understand that how much this paper absorbs and doesn't bleed, and it's completely smudge proof as well. So here is the metallic brush pen. Again, I'm using a metallic brush pen of Bruce Rowe over here. And you can see it's completely bleed proof. Doesn't shows, only if shows against the light, but doesn't shows any else ways. Yes, this IGTV will be saved over here. Yeah, sure, Manlala Spice Uchetna, I can pull off another line for you to make you sure that it doesn't bleed. Multiple lines and yet completely bleed proof on the other half. The chaitime.studio, this is my newly launched grid books over here with a 5x5mm grid sheets printed on 100 gsm of white map litho paper, which is, as I'm demonstrating, completely bleed proof and very great for us mandala artists or lettering artists or any people who use grids for practice or working on something. So you can go ahead and definitely get them from our store, and the link is available in my bio over here. All right, so if anyone of you have any questions regarding my grid books over here, or anything in particular about mandalas, or something which you wish to ask for a long period of time, so this is the right time. You're most welcome, Sucheta. Thank you so much, Shweta. The Chaitime Studio, these are currently at a launch offer price of Rs. 180 each. You can also get them at a combo offer with the Bruce Rowe 0.1mm fineliner at Rs. 245 as well. Thank you so much, Veena ji. Mandalas by Suchetna, this each one of the grid books cost Rs. 180. And if you go ahead and wish for the combo of the Bruce Rowe fineliner 0.1mm with this grid book, it's Rs. 245. And this is a launch offer price available till the end of this month, that is 30th of April. So you can go grab them. The link is given in my bio. These books have 50 sheets over here. That means 100 pages front and back, which you can go ahead and use without worrying of the paper leaking or bleeding or showing through from the other side. And they are 100 gsm paper, so it's quite thick and very sturdy for your pattern practice, your lettering practice, or bullet journaling, or any kind of works that you go ahead and do with your grid sheets. Art Card by Shweta, this is one of the covers. It is available in another cover as well. You can choose whichever cover suits you best or whichever cover you like most. So these are the two covers that it is available in. One is a bit of on the cooler side, another one is a bit on a warmer side, or a galactic tone over here. So these are the two covers of the grid notebooks. They are available in A5 size, and you can get any one of them, or get both of them, or get any one of them with the combo offer of Bruce Rowe fineliner 0.01mm tip. Yeah, Manya Gupta 2006, this IGTV will be saved, so you can always go ahead and scrap back to this. Alright, so let me just flip the camera towards my side now. Hello everyone, so good to see you here. I was really really excited to go ahead and launch this grid box, which I find it very very amazing, and I am obsessed with using this, and this is something which I required for a long period of time, and finally to get them and work for them and going ahead and find the perfect things for it. I'm really really happy, really really excited, and I cannot go ahead and wait to see how you all create your masterpieces on this grid book. Thank you so much, Mandalas by Sucheta. Glad you like the cover. This is something I picked up from my style and thought this would go perfectly with the cover of this grid books. Alright anyone, I'm just taking for a few more minutes. So if you have any queries or any questions regarding this grid books or anything in particular, you can throw them at me and I'll be more than happy to answer you all.